When I think about my call to vocational ministry, the first thing that comes to my mind was when I was a teenager. I was attending Central Church of the Nazarene at that time, and I still remember when our pastor's wife asked me to help them teach the Daily Vacation Bible School as one of the teachers. At that time, I was about 12 or 13 years old, and from then on, I participated as one of the Sunday school teachers at a young age. So when I attended a youth camp, I sensed the Lord calling me to ministry. But at that time, my father just became a pastor when I was 15 years old, and there was a shift in the way we lived our lives. So my initial reaction was, oh, I don't want to be a pastor. I want to earn a lot of money so that I can spend it on all the things that I want. But after that year, when I attended the youth camp again, the Lord's burden that He has put in my heart about how there are so many people that need to hear the good news, and that He wants me to be a part of His work in the kingdom as a pastor, as a leader, just became heavy in my heart. So I decided to follow Him, and I told my parents that I was gonna go to Bible school because I wanted to prepare to become a pastor. So when my father became a pastor when I was 15 years old, we were assigned to a church in Taytay, Rizal. My father asked me to help out with the young people and with the children. And I would say that he was a big advocate for me because he could just say that, oh, I was still young and I couldn't do it. But he believed that the Lord has given me the gifts and the graces, and that I can also participate in the work. When I finished the Bible school and my father resigned from the pastorate so that he could teach in the Bible school in Luzon, the church board presented my name as one of the pastors that they were going to vote on and invite to pastor the church. And there were many men in that church board, not just women, also men. And I would say that the fact that they all believed in God's call for my life was a big encouragement to me. I was just 22 years old back then, and I did not expect that they would actually choose me. That's what I want to say to encourage all of the women who are called into ministry, that our church encourages all of the people, no matter how young or how old you are. If you're a man or a woman, the Lord has a place for all of us at the table. One of the joys of serving as a woman in ministry is that I get to be that example to all of the young women and all of the women who feel like they cannot serve in the different capacities in the church. In the past, many of the women would look at the room and in leadership, and there's no one there. It's mostly men, and we are very grateful for them. But then to see just one woman standing along with the other men in leadership, it gives them an encouraging stance that, oh, the Lord calls women in ministry too. And that's joy for me, because when I see them take that step of faith and believe that the Lord and the Holy Spirit can fill them with whatever they need and mold them to be that leader like Jesus Christ, then that's like something I'm grateful for. In the Philippines, where I live, we always eat avocado as a dessert, like a sweet thing. And probably if you're hearing this and you've never done this before, it's such a strange thing. Because on the other side of the world, it's a savory thing, like guacamole, right? But when I was exposed to that dish, I realized that we can also do something different. And many times in the church, we do things because that's what we know. We have never seen other things. But the Lord is a redeeming God, and He can always make all things new, and we can try different things. What I want to say to the young women or young girls who are considering following Jesus in the ministry is this: you are created in the image of God. You have all the creativity that our Creator has, and you are called to partner with Him in this world so that we can make this world a better place. We can also take part in that with all of our gifts and all of our talents and our whole being. So just take that step of faith, because if you feel like you don't have what it takes, He will give you what you need to partner with Him. It's not our work alone. We are partnering with Jesus and His work in this world. And it would be a fun journey because you will discover Him in a deeper way when you say yes, even though there are fears and there are challenges in your context. Also, another thing I want to say is that even if people say no or people don't give you opportunities to serve in the specific ways that you're looking at, just keep finding the opportunities and the areas where you can serve. Because when people see your faithfulness in the little things, they will open the doors for you. And the Lord will just keep providing and presenting the opportunities